गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ आवर सिमिलर चैप्टर पीरियोडिक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स, एज यू नो ऑन द लास्ट टर्न वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स ऑफ मेंडेलीव पीरियोडिक टेबल. एंड ड्यूरिंग द डिस्कशन वी हैव फाउंड दैट मेंडेलीव वाज द फर्स्ट who had worked much in the formation of periodic table. But when he had proposed a periodic table in the year 1871, because at the time the concept of atomic number and electronic configuration was not known, that's why he could not consider that. He has considered the properties on the basis of atomic mass. After Mendeleev, mostly in the year 1913, formed the modern periodic law, and according to that law, his law, the properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic number. When after Mendeleev's periodic table, when this atomic number was discovered or atomic number was calculated, then modern periodic law was given by Moseley, and he has given the law that the properties of elements are periodic function of their atomic number. Mean in place of atomic mass, atomic number was made base of the modern periodic table. Now we will talk about modern periodic table. It is the systematic arrangement of elements into groups and periods on the basis of similarity in chemical properties and in order of their increasing atomic number. So this is the modern periodic table. This arrangement is also called as long form of periodic table. Now what were made the basis of modern periodic table? So in modern periodic table, elements have been arranged on the basis of following properties. These properties are as follows. Number one, increasing atomic number. Mean first of all, increase of atomic number was taken as the base. Then similarity and dissimilarity of electronic configuration of the valence shell of atom, or number of electron in outermost shell. This was also made the base for the modern periodic table. Then similarity and dissimilarity of chemical properties of elements. Then what are the similarity and dissimilarity between the chemical properties of elements? Now first of all we will talk about atomic number. Atomic number is the number of protons, as protons in the nucleus of an atom. As we have discussed this in class 9th, atomic number, it is the number of protons in the nucleus of an atom. And this number increases by 1 in going from one element to another. When we go from one element to the next, atomic number increases by 1. So when the elements were arranged in order of increasing atomic number, it gives the proper classification and it forms the basis of modern periodic table. Now we will discuss how anomalies of Mendeleev's periodic table are explained by modern periodic law. So first of all we will talk about position of isotopes. As we know, the isotopes of an elements have equal atomic number, they have same electronic configuration and same number of valence electrons. Therefore, all the isotopes of an element having same atomic number find the same position in modern periodic table. For example, the isotopes of chlorine, these are chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. They have the atomic number 17. So now this problem is solved as atomic number is taken as the base for the modern periodic table. So each isotopes of the same number of valence electrons and the chemical properties of each isotope are the same. Second problem, second that was there in Mendeleev periodic table, that is explanation of wrong order of atomic masses. When some elements having were placed wrongly according to atomic masses. So in modern periodic table, explanation of the wrong order of the atomic masses of some elements was solved. For example, cobalt and nickel, which were earlier placed in same sort, because they both have atomic mass of 59. But when we talk about atomic number, they have atomic numbers cobalt 27 and nickel 28. So they are placed in two different groups in modern periodic table. Third, explanation of a group of chemically dissimilar elements. When Mendeleev has placed chemically dissimilar elements in one similar group, so this problem was also solved in a modern periodic table. The elements like lithium, sodium and potassium are placed in group 1, while copper, silver, gold are placed separately in group 11 of modern periodic table. Now, arrangement of elements in different groups. How elements are arranged in different groups in modern periodic table? So, as we know, elements in the vertical column of the modern periodic table are called are arranged in groups, or the vertical column of the periodic table is called group. There are 18 groups in periodic table, and these groups are also called families of elements. The elements with a similar electronic configuration of the valence shell of their atomic atoms belong to the same group. Elements of, if we talk about the elements of group 1, so groups, as we know, these are arranged like that, hydrogen, then sodium, lithium and then sodium. Hydrogen, as we know, its atomic number is 1, and lithium atomic number 3, and sodium atomic number 11. So if we write the electronic configuration as of it, it has one electron, so it has only one shell, that is K, and it has two shells, two, and having electrons 2 and 1 distributed as 2 and 1, and in sodium they are written as 2, 8 and 1. But they all have one electron in outermost orbit. So they belong to group 1. So there are elements, there are 7 elements in group 1 of the periodic table, and except hydrogen, this hydrogen, all other elements of this group are metals. Lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium and francium, so these are the other 6 elements. We find that each element of group 1 has one electron in its outermost shell.
means all have one electron in outermost shell or valence shell. And if we talk about the group 2, so there are 6 elements in group 2, and these are beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium, and these are the members of group 2, and each has 2 electrons in outermost shell. If we take example of beryllium, magnesium and calcium, they have atomic number beryllium 4 and then magnesium 12 and calcium 20, and they have electron configuration like that, beryllium 2 when K and L shell and having 2 electron in L shell. And if we talk about magnesium 2, 8 and 2, its electronic configuration. And if we talk about calcium, it is 2, 8 and 2. So all these 3 have 2 electrons in outermost or valence shell. So they belong to group 2. So this is all about groups in modern periodic table. On next turn, we will talk about periods and other properties that are discussed in modern periodic table. So that's all for today.